Tonight, one suspect dead, one on the run. A shifting manhunt after murderous mass stabbing in Saskatchewan. Two brothers and a chilling chain of events.
The deceased is Damian Sanderson. Miles Sanderson is still at large.
Communities grieving and gripped with fear.
Now I'm terrified to go to sleep at night.
A Canadian tourist town in the line of fire.
We went to the lake and we're like, oh, it's getting bigger and bigger.
The ripple effect of raging wildfires.
No power this morning.
Yeah, I couldn't do anything.
Plus, big challenges for Britain's next prime minister.
I campaigned as a conservative, and I will govern as a conservative.
The high-level handover as Liz Truss takes the reins.
CTV National News with Omar Sachedina.
Good evening, everyone. I want to begin tonight's broadcast by thanking you for tuning in. It is a tremendous honor to be here with you. It has been a busy Labor Day Monday, so let's get to it, starting with new developments in the deadly stabbing rampage in Saskatchewan, where police revealed today one of the two suspects is dead. The body of Damian Sanderson was found today, while Miles Sanderson remains on the loose. Police confirmed they were brothers. That means 11 people were killed and 18 injured in 13 crime scenes around the James Smith Cree First Nation and the village of Weldon. That's where our coverage begins tonight with CTV's Jill McEachon. Welcome back. We typically cover the news, but lately we have become the subject of it. Over the past few weeks, Canadians have been having important discussions about ageism, sexism, and racism. The fact that we can have these conversations and learn from them is one of the hallmarks of this great country and reminds us of the role we all have in making it even better. Half a century after my parents were expelled from Uganda and were welcomed by compassionate and generous Canadians from coast to coast to coast, starting this journey with you tonight means a great deal to me. And it validates the promise of possibility. But I am just one part of a tireless team determined to share stories with you about what matters to Canadians and brings us together. Our mission is to do that objectively, with balance, and with different perspectives. Finally, it is important for me to acknowledge the inspiration and mentor that Lisa Laflamme has been to me over the years. Lisa, thank you for everything. Like many of you, I really wish Lisa's goodbye could have been from here. I know welcoming me into your homes every night is not a right. It's a privilege. I will work hard with our team to earn and build your trust for that continued privilege. That's my commitment to you. And that is our commitment to you. For all of us at CTV National News, thank you for watching. Good night and see you tomorrow.
CTV National News, Canada's number one newscast. 5 crucial questions to expose the truth. Who's at risk? What needs to change? When will justice be done?
There was actually a plot to kill you.
Where's the proof? Why did this happen? Watch W5 Saturdays at 7 on CTV. Across the Maritimes, in your community and beyond, CTV News is there. On the front lines, your local team brings news that matters to you. CTV News Atlantic, your home for news.
Good evening, I'm Suzette Beliveau for Monday, September 5th. This is CTV News at 11:30. Tonight, remembering Pat's Day, tributes pour in for Nova Scotia rapper killed Sunday morning. Then back to school, last minute preparations ahead of the first day back to class. And cruise ship comeback. Business owners optimistic about fall cruise season.
Live from our Maritimes News Center, this is CTV News. Here is Suzette Beliveau.
Thanks for joining us. Tributes are pouring in tonight for a Nova Scotia rapper killed in Halifax over the long weekend.